Most of times, so many people don't get selected in the diversity lottery visa program, not like they are not qualified, but because they make some unrecognized errors or are totally ignorant of so many points to take into consideration. In today's video, I'll be pointing out the 7 most common errors people make while applying for this. If you are new to the channel, welcome. Be sure to subscribe and turn on notification in order to get notified in real time every time I come up with a new video. In no particular order, the first reason people get rejected is failure to complete the form. Make sure your DV application is completely correct. Inaccurate information on your application will result in automatic disqualification. Make sure your name, date of birth, and all other required information pertaining to you and your family are correctly entered in your original DV application form. Make sure the photo attached to your application are your photos. If you use an internet cafe or other service to help you enter the diversity visa program, make sure the information is exactly correct and there are no mistakes. If you are not married when you enter the DV program and your name is selected for an interview, do not be persuaded to marry a stranger for money so that they can also get a diversity visa. This is the most common form of diversity visa fraud, and it results in both the principal applicant and the spouse being denied visas and banned from entering the US for life. Be smart, don't do this. Nobody can guarantee you a diversity visa. If someone tells you they can guarantee you a DV, they are not telling you the truth. Do not waste your money or your chance to get a diversity visa by falling prey to offers from people who say they can guarantee you a visa. Do not commit fraud of any kind when entering the DV program. Failing to list your spouse and or children on your application. You must include all requested information related to your spouse and children under the age of 21 on your application, whether or not they intend to immigrate to the US with you. This includes all your adopted children and stepchildren. You must also include the children of spouses you are no longer married to. Failure to list your spouse and all your children will result in automatic disqualification of your diversity visa application if should in case you are selected. Not having the requisite education and or work experience. To qualify for the diversity visa lottery, you must have either graduated from high school or have 2 years of work experience within the past 5 years in a field that typically requires 2 years of training. You necessarily do not need to meet both of these requirements. Only one of the two, you are good to go. But then, if you seek to meet the requirement through work experience, consult the US Department of Labor online database through the link on your screen. Your occupation must be classified with a job zone 4 or 5 with a specific vocational preparation score of 7 or more. Submitting more than one lottery application in the same registration period. If you submit more than one application for a diversity lottery during one open registration period, your applications will all be rejected. While you cannot submit 2 applications under your name, spouses can each submit their own application and list their spouse as a derivative. This will increase each spouse's chances of being selected, even though each person can apply only once. Submitting an invalid photograph. This is again another common reason many people don't get selected. You must submit a recent photograph. That is to say, a photo of yourself and co-applicants taken within the last 6 months. As a tip, go to a professional photographer and order for a photograph. To avoid complications, they should scale it to 600 by 600 and email you back the soft copy. You can now download the soft copy and use. Remember, the photographs you submit must be taken facing forward and in front of a plain background, preferably white. you cannot wear any hair covering unless it is for a religious purpose. Failure to submit a photograph that meets these regulations could result in the disqualification of your application. Before jumping into the last point, I would love to crave your indulgence to a video I did last week advising you on what to do in order not to get scammed in as much as the Diversity Visa Lottery program is concerned. Be sure to check out the link to this video in the description box below and stay safe. Finally, the seventh reason why you may get rejected is being inadmissible for previous unlawful presence, visa fraud, or criminal activity. In addition to correctly completing the Diversity Lottery application, you must meet the general requirements for admission to the United States. The US government won't look into this when you first enter the lottery, but it will if and when you win a slot. If, for example, you have spent more than 180 days unlawfully in the US, you may be subjected to a 3 or 10 year admission bar. Similarly, if you have ever lied or made a material misinterpretation on the US visa application, you may be found admissible to the United States. Finally, convictions for certain crimes like crimes involving moral turpitude, any two crimes with a combined sentence of 5 years or more, controlled sentences offenses, drug trafficking, prostitution, and other crimes make one inadmissible to the United States. Waivers are available for some of the grounds of admissibility, so it is important to consult an immigration attorney if you think this may be an issue for you. Wishing you all the luck as you apply this year. Thanks for watching. Remain positive and see you in the next video.